Welcome to BTEC Revision. In today's lesson, we will be able to express logarithms in exponential notation. Let's start with the question. What's the value of x here? 10 to the power of a number is 100 here. That number must be 2, as 10 squared is 10 times 10, which equals 100. If you remember from last lesson, we defined these values. We say that 10 is the base and 2 is the power or index. And the 100 is a number. Say here that 10 is the base, x here is the power or index, and the 100 is the number. We can also write this in algebraic notation as n equals base to the power p. Another way to say this is exponential notation. Now let's look at some more examples. Let's take 10,000 equals 10 to the power of x. What is x going to be? 10 squared is equal to 100. 10 cubed is going to be equal to 1,000. So this has to be 10 to the power of 4, which equals 10,000. Another example could be 8 equals 2 to the power of x. What is x going to be? If the value of x was 2, then that would be 2 squared, which is equal to 4. So it can't be 2. If you move on to the next number, 3, 2 cubed would be 2 times 2 times 2, which equals 8. So the answer is 3. Now let's move on to a more difficult question, one that we can't do in our head. I can ask if 9 equals 2 to the power of x, what is x? We know it's going to be a little bit more than 8 from the previous question, but by how much? This is where logarithms come into play. Logarithms, or logs for short, are a mathematical operation that can calculate powers for you. Let's take our previous example of 100 equals 10 to the power of x. Using logs, we can write this as log to the base 10 of 100 is 2. One thing to note here is if there is no base written, then it is 10. So we can write that like this. Here we can see that the base 10 goes here, the number 10 is here, and the power goes here. So we can write that as P, N for number, and B for base. Putting this back into its original form, or exponential notation, we can start with the B for base, which is 10, and the power associated with that is going to be 2, and that's equal to the number 100. The key to being confident in logs is to remember this conversion. Now let's look at some examples to solidify our learning. If we take log to the base 2 of 8, which is equal to 3, we can say that 2 raised to the power of 3 is equal to 8. Again, in exponential notation, we can write this as 2 to the power of 3 is equal to 8. We'll try this example on your own. So that's log 3 to the 9 equals 2. So here we can say the base 3 raised to the power of 2 equals 9. So writing that as 3 to the power of 2 is equal to 9. Replacing all these values with letters, as in algebraic notation, brings us onto the general equation. Let's replace the numbers. Here we have log to the base, we replace that with b, and 9 is the number, replace that with n, which is equal to p for the power. We can also do the same with this, which is b for base p for power equals n for the number. Here we have the general formula for logs. Remember, if there is no base written, then its value is going to be 10, and we can use this formula to easily work out a power using our calculator. We should now be able to convert from notation to notation. Finally, we will have a special case where we will use a special number called Euler's number, e. The value e is equal to 2.71828128, and so on. E is a special number, a little bit like pi. If we replace the base of a log with e, the notation changes to ln. So therefore, we can write log to the base e is equal to ln. Now pause the video here and complete these questions. Okay, starting with question 1, we have the base as 10 to the power of 3 is equal to 1000. For question 2, 3 to the power of 3 is equal to 27. Question 3, we have 3 to the power of 2 is equal to 9. Question 4, that's 5 to the power of 2 is equal to 25. And question 5, we have 3 to the power of negative 2 is equal to 1 over 9. For question 5, we have to find the value of x. We have base 3 to the power of 1 is equal to x. Therefore, x equals 3. Question 6, we have ln, which has a base e, log to the base e. Therefore, we can replace that base with the e here to the power of 1 is equal to x. So, x equals e. Question 7, we have another base e, power of x is equal to 1. Now, if you remember from last lesson, any number to the power of 0 is equal to 1. So therefore, x has to be 0. Question 8, we don't have a base written here. So therefore, we assume it to be 10. So we can say 10 to the power of x equals 10. Therefore, x must be equal to 1. Question 9, we would write base 10 to the power of x is equal to 100. So in order to get the value of x, we want the bases to be equal. So we can write 100 as 10 to the power of 2. Therefore, x has to be 2. And lastly, for question 10, we have base 10 to the power of x is equal to 10 to the power of negative 1. Therefore, x must be equal to negative 1. And for the last set of questions, express the following in logarithms. So we can write this as log. Then we would write the base, which is 5. And the number here is x, and that's equal to the power, which is negative 1. And for question 12, that's log to the base x, and the number z, which is equal to the power y. And that's the end of the lesson. If you would like to boost your grades, why don't you join us at btecrevision.com, sign up for online learning, where there are a lot more resources available. See you next lesson.